on Sportsway, the guests get involved in asking the guests the questions. Jimmy Johnson and Ken Norton will give you the diplomatic answer. But if you want the truth, you talk to James Washington on Sportsway.
Live from Miami Subs Grill in Dallas, Texas, with the music of Emerald City, this is Sports Waves. Now, here's your host, Mike Ducey.
Hi, everybody, and welcome to Sports Waves. I'm Mike Ducey. A big hour ahead. We'll talk about what was probably the most exciting weekend so far in the NFL, some great games. We'll talk about some other things as well. James Washington, who you just saw, will be our guest in a little while. Also, Ken Norton from San Francisco. And first, let me introduce my co-host for today's show, former head coach of the Dallas Cowboys, currently with Fox and HBO, Jimmy Johnson. Jimmy, welcome. This past Sunday, probably in terms of excitement and closeness of games, was the best you've seen. Every game but one was decided by 7 points or less. Good weekend of football.
Yeah, it was a good weekend, but of course, you know, when you have a good weekend as far as tight ball games, you're going to have half the country not real happy with the outcome, and you're going to have half of them really happy. And, you know, just like the San Francisco-Dallas game, I felt like, you know, I'd probably get a few people upset a little bit when I said I felt like San Francisco was going to win the ball game. But I said this, I said, I think that the Dallas Cowboys have the best team in football. And one thing that James Washington's heard me say many times, I said, you know, it really doesn't make a difference who's got the best team in football. I said, who's going to play the best this particular day? And I felt like San Francisco, because they had focused in and they had pointed toward that game for a solid year, they were really going to give a fanatical effort and really have a great ball game. And I think for that one ball game and that one day, they were a better team. But I think the Dallas Cowboys are the best team in football still.
Since 1981, the Niners have never lost four straight games to any opponent. Sunday at the Stick, San Francisco looked like a team that had everything to prove, but despite their efforts, the difference in the game was the performance of Dallas quarterback Troy Aikman. A bone spur in his right thumb may have been a bigger factor than even Aikman was willing to admit after his three-interception performance.
This is not the Troy Aikman performance that Cowboy fans have come to expect. While some of his numbers were glossy, 23 completions and 42 attempts and 339 yards, another number was troublesome. The man who led the Cowboys to an average of 31 points per game in the last three wins over San Francisco today can lead his offense to just two touchdowns. Was a thumb injury suffered Friday a factor?
I was not 100% sure that I would be playing yesterday. It was not a factor on the turnovers that I had. There were different throws during the ball game that I was not as accurate with.
You know, the turnovers were kind of freak, too. They had one legitimate Oski. The other two were, should have been caught.
That third interception came with Dallas driving to tie the ball game in the fourth, but Merton Hanks again came up big.
I had a 17-tackle, two-interception game back in high school at Lake Highlands High School. So that's, to me, my biggest game, but this is right up there.
Dallas outgained San Francisco by 100 total yards, but the turnovers, combined with the fact that Emmitt Smith could manage just 26 second-half yards, made all the difference.
I thought we moved the ball very well up against them in the first half, and I mean, we was picking up 4 or 5 yards of pop on the ground the first half, and second half, I mean, they tightened up on defense and played a lot better against the run in the second half than they totally did in the first half.
Oh, no, Coach said that all week. He said that they're going to get one or two plays, and we're still going to shut them down after that. So they got the one or two plays, and we shut them down.
And Young is back to throw.
This win proves that we are a team to be contended with, and really nothing more right now.
Touchdown.
Absolutely nothing more. That's it. But yet we needed that to prove that. Until we did, then we could only talk about it. So this game gave us a chance to prove that we're a team to be contended with.
So the Niners finally get it done against Dallas. Does that put any doubt in the back of the Cowboys' minds for the potential next meeting?
I don't think our football team fears coming in and playing against these guys.
We'll kick their ass the next time. I guarantee you that.
James Washington with a guarantee. Did he pick that up from you, that guarantee business?
Yeah, he grabbed the camera just as he's making that statement, and So he felt real good about it. James, he never has, you know, really missed any words on this thing. He tells it exactly how it is. Just like he said in the promo before, he said he tells the truth.
We'll be back with much more with Jimmy Johnson and more. Stay with us. Sports Waves continues in a moment.
Sports Waves is brought to you by Apex. Authentic NFL Pro Line apparel available at Foot Action. For every action, there's Foot Action. By American Airlines, something special in the air. By MGM in Las Vegas, the world's largest hotel, casino, and theme park. And by Miami Subs Grill, great food served fast. We'll be right back with more from Ken Norton. And stick around for Dennis Miller and James Washington, all tonight on Sports Waves.
Yeah. Why was I humming? As if I knew who could carry the flame.
Welcome back to Sports Waves. James Washington's one of the leaders of the Dallas Cowboy defense. In many minds, he was the MVP of the Super Bowl last year. He joins us now on Sports Waves. James, obviously a disappointment in San Francisco this past Sunday. How'd you guys approach the ball game coming in, and what were your feelings after the loss to the Niners?
Well, our approach is just like every week. Try to stop the run and make them pass. As a defense, I only speak as a defense, and the focus is the same focus we have every week that we go out. And we didn't expect Steve Young to be the running back that day, though.
James, really last year was Butch Davis's first year as defensive coordinator, and doing a great job. Y'all are number one ranked in the NFL as total defense right now, and just playing great defense. Hey, y'all, how has it been, you know, playing for Butch Davis as a defensive coordinator?
Well, it's basically it's the system that you guys brought from Miami, and it's, you know, grew on most of the guys that's there. We've been in the system 3 to 4 years, and you learn a system, you perfect the system, and we just try to play in the rules. We don't veer away from it much and try to be consistent. And Butch is, you know, he's a person that can prepare you for a ball game, and that's what he's done.
James, we want to give the folks a chance to see you in action. Take a look.
Roper and Jones in. Pass defense for the Cowboys, and the pass incomplete.
James, I will say, you love all those big hits, and the big hits, that gets the oohs and ahs with all the crowd, but the play I like more than the big hits was that last one when you recovered the fumble and put it in the end zone to turn the Super Bowl around, because that's one reason why I'm wearing this ring right now.
Hey, James, we have a bit of a surprise guest. We're going to see if we can get Ken Norton in from San Francisco right now. Turn around. Take a look at the mother. There he is. He's not going to be able to talk to you right now.
Oh,
okay, go ahead. Actually, we're all set to go with Ken Norton. James, anything you'd like to ask Ken about the ball game yesterday?
So, Ken, since you guys played your Super Bowl last week, yesterday, I would say, how you guys feel?
I'll tell you, I wouldn't quite put it in the ranks of the Super Bowl, but I think that for this organization, considering the Cowboys have beat them the last three times, 1 out of 4 is not bad.
Kenny, I don't know if he got a monitor there or not. I like your NFL on Fox. You must have seen the studio show yesterday. I was bragging on you, and I was talking about the transition, playing a different scheme of defense. You know, and you had a great ball game yesterday. How has it been going from the Dallas defense to the San Francisco defense, doing some different responsibilities?
I tell you, Coach, the Dallas defense is very different from this defense. This defense, we might play four or five defenses on a given motion, and this defense changes as the offense moves, and I think that early on it's a little difficult for me getting into all the different changes. But I think as the season goes on, I'm getting better at it.
Kenny, we're having a little trouble with your audio. We're going to try to come back to you in just a few minutes. If you would stay with us, we'd appreciate it, and we'll come back to you in a few minutes here on Sports Waves. James, Kenny had no trouble with his audio during the game this past Sunday, though. He was talking a little bit out there, wasn't he?
Kenny's like, you see, I wish Emmett would have ran down his chest a little bit more. You wouldn't have heard much from him, but that wasn't the case. You know, one thing about Ken is that he's always been able to get up for the big games and make plays, and then if he makes the play, you'll hear him all day.
Yeah, well, now that let's go back to your big hits. Now, how do you feel? I mean, I know a lot of people out there probably don't understand the game of football, but, you know, when you make that big hit on that receiver or that running back, does it hurt you?
It all depends. Like, I hit Taylor yesterday, and the impact on the hit, yes, he flew back 5 yards, but I didn't go nowhere, so therefore it's like Taylor's a big receiver.
Right.
And most of the impact hits me, and it kind of messed up my ribs a little bit.
It's kind of like a parent punishing a child. You say, it's going to hurt me a lot worse than it's going to hurt you.
Yeah, basically, but, you know, but once I see it on film, it's all good because I said
I didn't see you laying on the turf kind of grabbing your rib after you hit him.
I know, because I had, obviously, it was the first down. I had to keep on playing.
Let's go to our studio audience now. Question for James. Here's Mark Meter.
Hey, thank you very much, Mike. And I'll tell you what, you can tell when Jimmy Johnson's in the house because we have an extra excited, extra large crowd here in Miami Subs tonight, including all the way from Las Vegas to Nevada, Neil Lewis with a question for James Washington. Neil?
James, hi. I witnessed the game yesterday, and I'd like to know your opinion on Deion Sanders' performance.
I think that his performance was okay, but there goes again when you have a superstar cornerback who's capable of holding on the receivers and pull them down, and the referee just don't make that call. I mean, kind of like a situation, I'm not quite a superstar yet, but the referees expect me to run into people, so sometimes I might not get a flag thrown because that's what they expect. And Deion was kind of holding on our receivers a little longer than expected. And I think Alvin, you know, had an opportunity to beat him a couple more times, but, you know, we fell short.
Back into our studio audience, Maddie with a special guest.
Thanks a lot, Mike. We have a question now for James Washington, a SportsWave sports fan. What would you like to ask James?
Well, James, how do you think Ken Norton, knowing the Cowboys, was a deterrent for the Cowboys?
Well, it couldn't really be that much different because we don't change our defense that much. We play the same defense, and it's basically you have to come out and beat our defense. It's not that we're going to alter our scheme to try to make it better for, you know, for the offense. We play the same scheme so too many people don't have to make too many mistakes and just be aggressive and run to the ball.
Ken Norton is with us again now from San Francisco. Ken, how much did your knowledge of the Cowboys help your San Francisco team this past Sunday, do you think?
Not a whole lot. Like James says, everything you see is really on the film. There might be a few little details that I might have been able to help them with, but overall, a lot of stuff you see on film. There's not a whole lot I can do.
Kenny, I've got to ask you this. I was watching the game. I was very curious during the game because I know you do a little talking during the game, and I was just wondering if you were hollering, "Ain't no gimmies out here! Ain't no gimmies out here!" Were you hollering that during the game?
I think Harper and I might have said that a few times.
I've got to tell. I'll make a real quick story to everybody. We were in training camp. We had a little white fullback, about 230 pounds. Must have been about 5'8". And Kenny, you know, he had been holding out. He came into camp late, and he says, "Ain't no gimmies here." And we had a scrimmage going, and this little fullback hit him right up under the chin and knocked him cold. We carted Kenny off.
Yeah.
Kenny, we appreciate you joining us. It could be interesting when the Cowboys and the Niners meet again later on, assuming they do. Everybody will look forward to that rematch. Thanks for joining us, Ken Norton. You'll receive a suit from Lombardo Custom Apparel. I know you're familiar with that firm, and we'll enjoy that. We apologize for the audio trouble from San Francisco, but we do appreciate what we could hear and see of you on Sports Waves. Thanks a lot.
Congratulations, Kenny. Have a hell of a year.
That's Ken Norton from San Francisco. We have James Washington with us as well. What do you think, James? The prevailing feeling at the stick seemed to be that, okay, this was a regular season game, but these teams are on a collision course to meet again.
Well, I guess that's what makes it exciting about the NFL is that you have two dominant teams and people can look forward. Now, the next week, you know, the next 6 weeks, they're looking to see what San Francisco does and looking to see what Dallas does, and hopefully, you know, we both can win our division and have that bye week, and then we can rest up and beat the hell out of our opponent in the division championship, and then we'll meet in the NFC championship.
We're back with more on Sports Waves. Jimmy and James will come back. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
Somebody was spreading rumors about a better thing to come in, yeah. How would I know it? How would I know to tell your fame? I just whispered your name.
Music of Emerald City on Sports Waves, as always. Thanks for being with us. I'm Mike Ducey, Jimmy Johnson, James Washington. We're going to talk about the league in general just a little bit here in just a moment. A few surprise teams. I guess Cleveland looked very good this past Sunday, Jimmy.
Well, you know, Cleveland started out with a very soft schedule their first part of the year, and you know, I think a lot of people felt like that once they got into the meat of their schedule that they'd really start to falter, but they played outstanding against Philadelphia yesterday, and I think because they're so solid on defense, and that comes from Bill Belichick, not only, you know, having a defensive background, but, you know, he makes a lot of the personnel decisions there at Cleveland, and he's been able to bring in a lot of players that have won Super Bowls, that have Super Bowl rings, and on top of that, that fit his system, and so they're playing outstanding defense, giving up fewer points than anybody in the league. And it looks like that they're going to be a solid team the rest of the way out in the AFC.
James, you've got that Cleveland team coming down the road a little bit. You got Philadelphia as well. But you're going to tell me you take them one game at a time and all that stuff.
Yeah, I mean, that's true. Yeah. That's how we do. I mean, to speak about Cleveland, obviously they're playing great defense because they got a safety from UCLA, Eric Turner, who's leading the league in interceptions, I think. And he's playing well and aggressive.
Let's talk more about the league this past weekend. The NFL has six games remaining in the regular season. Tony Martinez tells us that the battle by the Bay was just one of 14 games played on Sunday.
Believe it or not, there were other stories in the NFL yesterday besides the Steve, Jerry, Troy, Michael, and Emmett show. God ain't made a better back in this lifetime, says Wayne Font. Barry Sanders running away with the rushing title, 237 yards in the Lions' win against the Bucks. The Eagles already looking ahead to Dallas on December the 4th, surprised by Cleveland and Mark Griffin, of all people. How did one future Hall of Famer do yesterday? Joe Montana leading the Chiefs' comeback against San Diego, intercepted by Darren Carrington. Chargers win the game. The Chiefs are 6-4, and most thought this team would be better with the living legend at quarterback. It took the weirdest play of the day to give the Bears their win against Miami. Dave Wonstadt called it swinging gate. Curtis Conway off the fake field goal with the pass, the planned deflection off Jerry Fontenot, and Keith Jennings runs it in for the simple 23-yard score, just like you drew it up, Coach. Incredible effort Sunday. Drew Bledsoe leading New England from a 20-0 deficit, throwing 70 passes, 426 yards, the game winner here in overtime. Bledsoe. Jeff Blake. Three touchdown passes to Carl Pickens, who scored two of them despite interference.
Throwing long for Pickens. He's got it at the two. Goes in. Touchdown.
The catch of the day by Bryant Reeves of the Cardinals, handing the Giants their seventh straight loss.
What a catch.
And finally, the hit of the day in Scottsdale, Arizona.
Bonus highlight. A bonus highlight for you. That was a guy named Michael Jordan getting hit in the back there. Last week, Paul Prudhomme went 2 for 4 on his celebrity picks, 1 for 3 in the games, and the chicken recipe was outstanding as well. That was kind of a bonus. This week, we return to the concert stage for our celebrity picks as country music star Steve Warner gives us this song and dance.
Did I tell her about it, Hush?
Straight ahead, right down the highway, out across New Mexico.
Hi, I'm Steve Warner, and check out this hat. I love this hat. Cleveland at Kansas City. Cleveland has been playing real well. My opinion is they're going to knock Kansas City off. But, of course, I like Kansas City. I like Montana, and I like Kansas City lights. But I'll have to go to Cleveland.
I got to ride.
Miami at Pittsburgh. I'm going to be in Miami tomorrow, but I think Miami's playing great, but it's Pittsburgh, I don't know. That's going to be a tough game. My guess is Pittsburgh's going to squeak it out with a last-minute field goal.
One more stop, fill her up, a cup of coffee and a piece of white.
All right, Philadelphia and Arizona. It should be real interesting, the Buddy ball, the connection with Buddy and Philly and Arizona, but I'm going to have to go with Philly big time on this one.
Keep on rolling.
Steve Warner, one of the great voices in country music. Let's pick the games here, guys. The three games, Kansas City and Cleveland, first of all, next week, Jimmy.
Well, I think because of Cleveland's defense, you know, they should be the winner. But the way I've been picking games on a couple of these things, I don't know if anybody should listen to me.
How about it, James Washington, Kansas City Chiefs, and Cleveland?
I'll take Cleveland over Kansas City because of the defense.
All right, Pittsburgh and Miami.
Pittsburgh!
Well, I hate to upset some of the patrons here, but I'm going to take the Miami Dolphins against Pittsburgh.
I'm not going to agree with that one because, again, we have a great safety from UCLA playing for Pittsburgh, and I just love great defensive backs.
You got to stick by those Bruins,
yeah,
too.
It's a Bruin thing.
All right. And finally, Atlanta and Philadelphia, or Arizona and Philadelphia, excuse me.
Well, you know, Buddy makes a spark every now and then, but Philadelphia's got the talent, and Philadelphia will win that ball game.
Hands down, Philadelphia. A team that's capable of exploding and easily probably stop their offense because Buddy, we know, don't play offense. He tries to create defense.
James Washington, the Dallas Cowboys, thanks for spending a few minutes with us.
Thanks for having me.
All right, James. Good to see you.
Still to come on Sports Waves, comedian Dennis Miller joins us from Las Vegas. He's a big sports fan. He'll talk about that, I presume, and many other things when we come back on Sports Waves. Stay with us.
Record-setting Sunday for New England's Drew Bledsoe. 69 attempts and 44 completions, and one more here for the record book and the win in overtime.
Touchdown.
Drew Bledsoe, Bill Parcells, Big Kahuna.
on Sports Wave. Mike Ducey with Jimmy Johnson. Jimmy, how about Drew Bledsoe throwing 70 times in a football game?
Well, you know, that game really turned around the second half. It looked like Minnesota had control of the game, and of course Minnesota's been playing great defense all year long. And then Drew Bledsoe, who I think is a tremendous talent, he is going to be a great player in this league for a long, long time. He came back that second half and just put it all over the field, and they ended up winning the thing in overtime. Just did a fantastic job.
The MGM Grand in Las Vegas is one of our sponsors on Sports Waves, and we're happy to welcome live via satellite from the MGM Grand a gentleman who is performing right now there, Dennis Miller. Comedian Dennis Miller joins us. You know Dennis Miller for his work on television, Saturday Night Live, his late night show, his HBO work now, and of course one of the really funny stand-up acts going. I know that means a lot to him to hear me say that. Dennis, thanks for joining us on Sports Waves. We appreciate it. Jimmy Johnson is here. I know you've admired Jimmy for a long time.
Yeah, well, I've met Jimmy a couple times at the ESPY Awards, and I kind of wanted to wear my hair a little windblown today to counterbalance Jimmy over there. I know he's cutting diamonds with that talc of his.
Well, the only thing is, see, now that I'm not actually coaching and I'm in the media business, I'm going to let my hair grow like yours. I might even have me a little beard.
You're a wild man. You're like Jimmy Buffett now. You're down there in the Caribbean with the bong.
All right. Dennis, I know that you're a big sports fan. What team in particular do you follow professional football?
Well, I grew up in Pittsburgh, but they've kind of disappointed me. So I like the Niners now. I follow the Niners, and I'm a fan of the Cowboys, too.
Okay, all right.
So you had to have
Well, put it this way. I never liked the Cowboys before, but now as I look at them, there's a good chance, and I'm not saying this to suck up. I know you're in Dallas, but just from a pragmatic standpoint, that might be the best football team I've ever seen in my life, so I have to give them a hand. They're tough.
Dennis, the status of sports in general, football is about the only thing going right now. The NBA avoided a lockout, but, baseball, they can't seem to get it together. Hockey can't seem to get it together. It's a tough time to be a sports fan, really.
You know, just last night I was over at Caesar's Palace, and I believe it or not, playing blackjack, I ran into Wayne Gretzky, and he told me that he's going to Europe to set up some barnstorming tour over there playing hockey in Europe. So I don't know if that augurs well for the National Hockey League strike. But you know what? These things probably have to happen. We've reached a pivotal time in American sports where the people who own the teams were just worried about the future of the league. They had to take a stand. The players are used to being coddled. They had to take a stand. I think this is good. I think it'd be good to have baseball take off for a year. Then maybe we could all get back to square one and start over again.
Dennis,
it's like a drunk. Baseball has to hit bottom before it can clean its act up.
Dennis, I'll probably see you here in a couple of days because I'm going to come out. I may run into Gretzky, too. I'm going to come out for the fight there at the MGM with the Tony Jones fight Friday night.
Yeah, looking at the odds here.
Yeah, uh-huh.
And James, Tony, Roy Jones, and then Riddick Bowe is fighting B. Arthur from The Golden Girls. I'm going to go with B. I don't know. That's me.
Well, I can get your tip on the fight here in a couple of days, but why don't you make a comment about the old man that went out there and struck one for the old guys, George Foreman.
Oh.
How about his fight the other night?
Well, you know what? Anytime you have 250 pounds, you've got a puncher's chance. And you know what? I think Moore at some point just... I don't think Michael Moore lived to be a heavyweight fighter. I think he thought it was a dangerous thing. He seems to adore his children from what I've seen. I think he got $7 million in the bank, and you know what I mean? It's tough to push yourself that hard. Maybe he didn't want it badly enough. Maybe Foreman wanted vindication from the Ali fight. So everybody, it comes down to who wants it the most. Obviously, George wanted it the most that night. But I don't think he wants Tyson.
Do you blame him?
He might think he wants Mike Tyson, but he does not want Mike Tyson.
Let's go to our studio audience. A question for Dennis Miller. Maddie?
Thank you very much. All the way from Los Angeles, California, we have a Sports Wave sports fan. Jane has a question for Dennis.
Hi, Dennis. I'd like to hear your latest NFL joke.
I have none. I'm sorry. Are you angry at me now? Drew Bledsoe throwing 70 passes for a Bill Parcells team is kind of funny.
Yeah.
It's a little humorous, isn't it?
Each week is Bledsoe throws more passes, his belt size enlarges, Parcells. I mean, he's starting to look like a Macy's balloon now.
We're going to come back with more on SportsWave. Dennis Miller is our guest. I'm Mike Ducey. Jimmy Johnson is here. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
You would not believe how much fun it is to be in the Sports Wave crowd here at Miami Subs Grill. If you plan on being in the Dallas area on a Monday, just write to the following address for reserved tickets. It's almost as fun as being at the Super Bowl, only the food's better here.
On Sports Waves, if you're in the Dallas area, we invite you to join us here at the show. You can either write to the corporate office, as mentioned, or stop by any of the Miami Subs Grill restaurants in the Dallas area. Sign up to join us here as we broadcast live every week in front of the rowdiest crowd in television history. Just like we scripted it, Jimmy.
Right, right.
Comedian Dennis Miller is with us.
That is an ass-kicker crowd you've got. That sounds like Bob Dole's basement on Tuesday night.
They've been getting pumped up here for an hour or two prior to the show. You know how that goes occasionally.
Yeah.
Hey, Dennis, everybody's been loving your stuff for years. I'm curious, because I'm in the front of the camera a little bit myself now. You know, how much of it is ad-lib? How much of it is rehearsed? You know, how much of it is given to you by writers, like on a regular show?
Well, you can see from the last segment when the woman asked me for an NFL joke how brilliantly I ad-libbed. You know what? My TV show's probably around 80% written beforehand and around 20% ad-lib. Unless, of course, Robin Williams is on, which he was a couple weeks ago, then it inverts and 80% of it's ad-libbed and 20%'s pre-recorded.
Yeah, yeah, I watched the Robin Williams and it looked like it was all ad-lib.
That's like a Brahma bull ride, Jimmy. You just hang on, man. They open that gate. Around 27 minutes later, you get off and your balls hurt.
It's a great show.
Let's go into our studio audience. A question for Dennis Miller. Mark?
Thank you very much, Mike. We have another NFL question for Dennis, but this time we're not going to put him on the spot with that joke stuff. I've got Mike Browning here with me from Dallas. Mike?
Dennis, you know, we've seen some pretty vicious hits on the quarterbacks this year, and I was wondering what your perspective is on maybe how the league is treating some of those pretty bad hits on the quarterback this year.
Well, you know what? Football's a pretty tough game. I remember Terry Bradshaw, when I used to follow the Steelers, getting thrown down on his neck by Joe Turkey Jones from Cleveland. I think there are obvious things, like I think Wilbur Marshall wanted to hurt him. So when they put the crown of their helmet on their chin, I think you got to do something against them. But short of that, it's a rough game. These boys know what they're doing. They're big, strong guys. Some of them are going to get hurt, but they know that going in. I think that's part of the action for them. They dig that in some perverse way. So short of hitting with the top of your helmet, I think they should let them play. They're grown-ups. It's a tough sport.
Don't you think, too, Dennis? In fact, Fox asked a comment from me on this the other day, and they made me kind of temper it down. And that's what the fans want to see. It's a violent sport. It's a contact sport. And the fans like to see the big hits. You know, and I think if they tone it down too much, I think it's going to probably turn some of the fans off. Don't you think or not?
Well, you know, I don't want to sound like one of these armchair guys who gets overly macho. I think when somebody hits somebody like Wilbur Marshall, hit Aikman head on with an intent to really hurt his head area, I would say that's wrong and you got to legislate against it. But short of that, I agree with you. Just the everyday run-of-the-mill hits, it's a tough game. And if they start waddling it down, if they turn it into Nerf football, nobody's going to watch, man.
Dennis, were you an athlete? Did you play sports in school at all?
Not at all. You know, that's why I wasn't an athlete, and that's why I'll go so far with criticizing athletes, because, you know, these guys who, like, want to posture about how tough they are but never get off their ass on any given Sunday, I won't do that. I think pro football players have a certain code they live by. I'm not privy to it because I'm not in that preternatural physical level they are. And I'm not going to point fingers at somebody who doesn't want to go across the middle, because I see Daryl Stingley come out occasionally, and I think it's a grim reminder of how real it is out there. So as far as I'm concerned, these guys, you know, they write their own rules. I'm not part of it. I'm just somebody who watches.
Dennis, I talked to you about this before we went on the air, but obviously you've been around a while now, and a lot of us have enjoyed your work. There's an anchor for ESPN by the name of Craig Kilborn, who does a late-night sports center, whose style just reminds me, and a lot of people when they watch him, of you. His humor, I think, is in some ways patterned after you. What do you feel when you see somebody maybe taking a page or two from your book?
Well, Craig and I were lovers, and...
you know, I'm good night, everybody. We'll see you next week.
I am out of here. I'm flattered. I think he's a funny kid. I'm a little pissed at ESPN, though. I'm not hosting the ESPYs this year. Thank you, guys. But I think Kilborn's a good kid.
Dennis Miller from Las Vegas. Tell us what you're going to be doing, what your schedule is at the MGM Grand, and talk a little bit about what's coming up for you.
Well, I do an interpretive dance show here, and
how long are you going to be there?
I'm there through next Wednesday. Jimmy, are you really coming in here?
Yeah, I'll be there day after tomorrow.
Well, call me at the MGM. Let's go out and eat.
Okay, I'll be ready.
You're coming
in for
the fight?
We can go out and do something.
What's that? Let's go break bread, man.
Yeah, I'm ready. A lot of the Fox crew's coming in for the fight, and so
you don't you don't go anywhere anymore without a TV crew up your ass. You're
like, all right, Dennis Miller, Las Vegas. Thank you. And we will come back to more.
All right,
this way. In just a moment. Stay with us.
She's a brick house. She likes a magic. Just let me all hang up. She's a brick.
Take your take.
Don't you just love nature? It's so natural.
Try to tame it.
So, Jay Lombardo, tell us, who is the best-dressed man at Lombardo's?
All my guys are the best-dressed. Take these guys, for instance.
Hey, we don't need the big board for this.
I'm the best.
Hey, nobody's looking better than me
on my show.
Problem is, Mikey, you got a bad show.
You need some pizzazz.
Pizzazz is not what I need. It's a good fit.
Tony, this is a perfect fit.
Sure, now, we need the big man with the chalkboard for this one.
Now, let's check on the bus.
What about us?
How about Mike?
Put action.
Emerald City on Sports Waves, and a special guest musician with them from the Dallas Cowboys. We'll keep it a secret for just a few more minutes, but we'll talk with them in just a moment. I'm Mike Ducey with Jimmy Johnson. Coming off that Dennis Miller segment, we'll try to get our composure back. There was a coaching change in the National Football League here recently. Jack Pardee out in Houston, Jeff Fisher in Houston. Your thoughts?
Well, I think Jeff Fisher's really an outstanding coach. He worked with Buddy Ryan there at Philadelphia, then he left. He was with the Rams for a while and went to Houston, and really doing a good job with their defense. I think, as far as, Jeff, he was an up-and-coming coach, and then... Bud Adams, you know how he is down in Houston. They've got the worst record in the league right now, and it's a big disappointment, so he made a change. And I think Jeff would do a good job down there.
Did Bud talk to you about that job?
No, I made it clear that I wasn't going to do anything this year. And in fact, I've made it clear that there's a good chance that I won't coach again. There's a chance that this at the end of the year, I'm going to look at the options. I'm going to make a decision. I'm going to have some opportunities to coach and possibly be general manager, and so I may do it, but again, I'm going to wait till the end of the season. I've got a commitment to Fox, and I'm going to go ahead and continue with that commitment right now, and I may stay with them. Never can tell. I may stay out another year and then get back into coaching after that. That's my oldest son, Brent. That's what he says I'm going to do, is stay out 2 years and then go back into it.
You got various people laying odds on what you're going to do, that's for sure.
Go to Houston.
All right, somebody says, go to Houston. All right, let's go out of the Emerald City Band. You enjoy their music every week on Sports Waves. Their special guest Mark Tuane of the Cowboys as well. Take it away, guys.
Mustang Sally. Yeah, yeah. I guess you better slow your Mustang down. All right. Mustang Sally now, baby. Oh, oh. I guess you better slow your Mustang down.
Is Mark Meter. Mark?
All right, Mike, thank you very much. And you may not recognize this guy as a bass player, but he's actually a pretty good one. And Mark, before we get started, what's more nerve-wracking, stepping on the field for the Super Bowl or getting up in front of a crowd and playing the bass?
Playing the bass definitely is a lot tougher.
Tell us how you got into this.
I'll tell you what, I'm thinking about my life after football. My wife's a singer, and I'm trying to get a band together with me and DJ so far, so... We got two of the components. He plays the drums and I play the bass. And my wife's a singer, so we're halfway there.
Of course, DJ Dennis Johnson, also of the Dallas Cowboys, and he plays drums. Mark, I know you've been suffering a little bit with a back injury. Is this bass hanging on you here causing you any problems?
No, actually it loosens me up a little bit. You know, I move around a little bit, it stretches the back out a bit.
All right, we've been hearing a lot about problems with the offensive line as far as injuries. How are you guys overcoming that? How are you guys playing with some of the problems? You're missing some players.
Yeah, of course, the biggest loss was Eric Williams, but Larry Allen stepped in and is playing outstanding for a rookie, and in fact, playing above his head, actually. And, you know, Derek Kennard's banged up a little bit with his toe, and, you know, Newton's banged up with his ankle, but we're doing all right.
We got a guy here that your former coach, Jimmy Johnson, and I'm not sure if he has a question or if he's going to volunteer as the lead singer for that new band. Jimmy?
Hey, Tua, you've got talents I never knew about. I knew Pono, she is a great singer, but now I've never seen this before. Now, where'd this come about?
Oh, actually, like I said, I'm thinking about starting a band, and DJ's got the drum started up, and my wife's always been a great singer, so we got a lot of catching up to do as far as catching up to her singing.
It looks like that Wojcik still has you at that 299 spot on the weight. You know, every time I check the weights, we had weigh-in every 2 weeks throughout the season for the last 5 years, and Tui was always at 299. I never could figure out how he could be at that same spot every time. One serious question. I see my fish tank in the background behind you. Are you still into the tropical fish?
Yes, I am, and they're actually living this time. I got them to stay alive this time, Jimmy. I know it's been a problem in the past, but now they're staying alive.
Mark Tuane of the Dallas Cowboys showing his talents that even his former coach didn't know he had. Mark Tuane, thanks for being with us tonight. You stay with us as we go to break. It's Emerald City with Mark Tuane. We'll be back.
Tell Casino and Theme Park. And by Miami Subs Grill. Great food served fast.
Back on Sports Waves with Jimmy Johnson. Jimmy and I talked earlier about the Cowboys 49ers game. In case you're just joining us, Jimmy liked the Niners early to win the game, but still feels the Cowboys are the better team. How about Aikman? Could you tell that he wasn't right on Sunday?
Well, it was really hard to see, but you know, you knew that he wasn't right for the simple reason he had some interceptions, because Troy doesn't throw interceptions. But you know, having that thumb, the way he grips the football, as firm a grip as he's got on it, it had to affect him, especially there late, because not only does he grip the ball, but he's taking the snap, and that had to take a pounding, because I know it was swollen. I know it was black and blue, and so he is not going to be as accurate with that thumb hurting the way he did. On top of that, he got hit in the nose, and so that had a negative effect, and it was a great ball game, but I think the next time they play, it probably could be a different result, because I don't know that the 49ers will be as prepared, and I think the Cowboys will be better prepared the next time around, because it'll happen.
All right, Jimmy, thank you very much for joining us on Sports Waves. We appreciate it. Be in the studio next week for Fox.
I'm there in Fox. Let's see, 12 o'clock Central Time.
All right. And next week on Sports Waves, a good show. Jimmy live from Los Angeles next week. Joe Gibbs live from Charlotte. And the MVP, Emmitt Smith, will join us live in the studio. Sports Waves is seen in over 40 markets across America, including our friends at WNPL-TV in Naples, Florida. Remember, if you're in Dallas, stop by any Miami Subs Grill and sign up to be a member of our audience. Thanks to our corporate sponsors, American Airlines, Foot Action USA, the MGM Grand in Las Vegas, and GMC Trucks. Also, thanks to our guests tonight, James Williams, Dennis Miller, James Washington, Dennis Miller, and Jimmy Johnson. I'm Mike Ducey. We'll see you next time on Sports Waves.
Everything is all right. Loving you so much. Everything is all right. Everything is all right. Loving you is all right. Everything is all right. Everything is all right. Loving you is all right.
Wardrobe by Lombardo Custom Apparel, America's finest custom clothier. Accommodations in South Florida provided by the Marriott Key Largo Bay Beach Resort. And in Dallas, Jimmy Johnson and his guests stay at the beautiful Melrose Hotel. Sports Waves is a presentation of DCL Media and Lone Star Hospitality Corporation.
...800-94-JENNY.
You won't just lose your wings.
1-800-94-JENNY.